A measure seeking to establish the Philippines' sovereign wealth fund gets the nod of the Senate. The controversial Maharlika Investment Fund bill was approved on third and final reading early Wednesday, just days after it was certified as urgent by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The approved bill has some major changes. These include explicitly prohibiting state pension funds like government service insurance system and social welfare system from investing in the Maharlika Fund.
The form that we are passing now, I think, satisfies our thirst for transparency and accountability on this measure. I think the number of amendments that we placed here will assure the Filipino people that this fund will be used properly, efficiently, and effectively.
19 senators voted in favor of the measure. Senator Nancy Binay abstained from voting, while Senator Risa Ontiveros voted against the bill.
I fully agree with the sponsor's belief that a new kind of public financing is needed. We need to learn how to leverage the capital resources that we have so that we could do more with the little that we have. My belief is that the idea of a sovereign wealth fund will make sense sometime in the medium term, perhaps when we have the surpluses. It's ahead of its time, so to speak.
Representatives from the Senate and the lower house will convene today to reconcile the differences between their versions of the MIF bill.
Economists questioning the rush in approving the Maharlika Investment Fund bill. For former Central Bank Deputy Governor Diwag Nigumbo, tapping dividends of Land Bank, Development Bank, and the BSP as funding sources for the Maharlika Fund may lead to higher taxes. He also warns it may result in an increased national debt if government runs out of money for priority programs.
Dalawa lamang o tatlo lamang ang maaaring gawin ng gobyerno upang ito ay makapag-compensate o makabawi doon sa mawawalang pondo, we have to be prepared not only to pay a higher level of taxes, yung pagbabayad ng mauutang para ipampuno doon sa mawawalang pondo na ibibigay naman sa Maharlika Investment Fund.
Former Finance Secretary Gary Teves meanwhile asserts government should attend to other more pressing matters instead of pushing for a sovereign wealth fund.
Mas mabuti yung matanong natin, ito ba ay importante at urgent? Sa tingin ko importante, pero hindi urgent. Eh. Kasi compared sa inflation, mas importante yun tsaka mas urgent. Kasi yun talaga, yun ang pulso ng taong ngayon based on the survey of SWS saka Pulse Asia. No? Mas importante and urgent pa nga yung concern sa anong gagawin natin sa pensyon ng those in military uniforms kasi makaka-apekto sa ating fiscal operations po yan eh.
Philippine prosecutors appeal a court's decision which acquitted detained former Senator Laila De Lima in one of her drug cases. They asked the Muntinlupa Court to reconsider its May 12th ruling and declare De Lima guilty of conspiring in the illegal drug trade. The motion submitted on May 27 questions the motive of former prisons chief Rafael Ragos for recanting his testimony against De Lima. It disputes Ragos' claim he was coerced to implicate De Lima in the narcotics trade inside the national penitentiary. De Lima's lawyer, Filibon Takadon, insists the petition is no longer valid, pointing out that the court's ruling was made with finality. Takadon says only the Supreme Court can decide whether the case may be reopened.
House Majority Leader Manuel Jose Dalipe defends alliance agreements with the Lakas CMB party list. He says the agreement reiterates support not only for Speaker Martin Romualdez, but also for President Marcos's legislative agenda. At least seven political parties inked an agreement reaffirming their ties with the Lakas CMB party list following an alleged leadership row in the House of Representatives.
It was a reiteration of the manifestation of support and cooperation because we in the House would like to work together, especially on the laws that were proposed to be passed and agreed in the LEDAC, we agreed to with the Senate that we'll be passing 42 of those laws that will benefit our people, our countrymen, benefit the Republic of the Philippines. So as a House, you know, we have 300 plus members, and we would want the House to be united, and we, together with the other parties, the Lakas CMD plus the other parties, reaffirm that commitment of support to the House leadership, and most especially to the House Speaker.
Amid the House drama, Deputy Speaker Gloria Macapagal-Arroyo joins President Marcos and Speaker Martin Romualdez in an event in Malacañang. According to Arroyo, the event was a courtesy call of the chairman of Thailand's largest business company. Arroyo said the conglomerate will expand their investments to help the Philippines develop a model value chain in the country. She noted the company started its investment in the Philippines during her administration. This marks Arroyo's first public appearance with the president and the House Speaker together. This comes after she denied planning an alleged coup plot against Romualdez, blasting reports that First Lady Liza Araneta Marcos was involved in the plot.
Former Social Welfare Secretary Irvin Tulfo takes his oath as representative of the Anti-Crime and Terrorism Community Involvement and Support, or ACT-CIS, of Romualdez. This after the Commission on Elections Second Division dismissed the disqualification case against the former broadcaster. But a motion for reconsideration over that ruling is pending at the COMELEC on back. COMELEC Chair George Garcia says it's up to the House leadership if it will allow Tulfo to perform his duties. The Commission on Appointments earlier bypassed Tulfo's appointment as a cabinet member due to citizenship issues. A former chief of the Philippine Police Drug Enforcement Group admits there were operational lapses in the 2022 raid that yielded more than 6 billion pesos of methamphetamine. Police Brigadier General Narciso Domingo says they should have done an inventory of the confiscated drugs immediately after the raid with the required witnesses.
I admit, Mr. Chair, Your Honors, that there are lapses in our entire operation, but such judgment calls and procedural lapses were done by me in good faith based on the reports of my men.
The Senate Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drugs wrapped up its probe into the raid Tuesday. But Committee Chairman Senator Ronald De La Rosa said he's willing to reopen the investigation if they hear from a certain Mike C, the alleged drug lord linked to the confiscated drugs.
Senator Risa Ontivero says Philippine offshore gaming operators, or POGOs, have now become a legal cover for scam hubs in the country. During a Senate hearing Tuesday, Ontivero called out the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation for allegedly failing to prevent the new modus. Ontivero says she is appalled that a fraudulent company, which has trafficked thousands of foreign nationals into the country to work as scammers, has been operating under the license of a legal POGO. The senator then reiterated her call to ban POGOs in the country.
Yung aming assertion na ang POGOs nagbukod sa kakarampot ang ibinibigay na economic contribution sa ating ekonomiya, bukod sa napakaraming social costs na sinisingil sa ating lipunan, siya pa pala ay nagbibigay ng legal cover sa mga criminal activities na ito.